So hey guys, what's up? I hope all of you are doing extremely well and welcome back to my channel. So today finally here it is again. I'm doing a question and answer video for you guys. I mean, I have been waiting for so long to film a video like this so that I could answer all your questions that you keep asking me on DMs and through messages and through reels. So I was like, mujhe ek question and answer video karna hi chahiye. So basically, I asked you guys to comment and leave your questions on a photo on Instagram yesterday, and a lot of you guys left your questions. Like, there were so many questions, almost 300 questions. So obviously I cannot answer all the questions that you guys asked me because it's impossible to put all those questions in one video. And also a lot of you guys ask a lot of similar questions. So what I did was I picked out the 20 best questions according to me. So I'm going to answer those 20 questions for you guys today. Also, I'm going to be mentioning all the names of people who asked me those questions down below, because tum log ka jo Instagram username hai, kaafi logo ka bahut zyada complicated hai bolne ke liye. So I don't want to mess that up. So I'm going to be specifying the names of people who asked me those questions and also their questions here, so you can read it for yourself properly and understand what they asked. So now, without wasting any further time, let's get into the video, because I am really, really pumped to answer all of your questions today. First question is from Varun, and he's asking me, is YouTube your full-time career or part-time? It obviously is not my full-time career, guys. I mean, you know that I'm not so regular on YouTube, or I mean, I have started being regular nowadays, but I do not put up like 30 videos in a month or 15 videos in a month, or not even 10 videos a month. So I try to film videos on YouTube as and when I can, but it's definitely not my full-time career. Let's go to the second question. It is from Vidit. He asked me, which software do you use for editing? Now, I don't know what do you mean by which software I use for editing for my YouTube videos or for Instagram. So since a lot of you guys asked me about Instagram photos and videos as well as YouTube, so I'm going to answer both of them. So for Instagram photos, I use Snapseed and Lightroom to edit my photographs. I just love Snapseed and Lightroom. They can make your, you know, I mean, they can take your Insta game to a whole new level altogether. So if you guys have not tried Snapseed and Lightroom, you should definitely give it a try. I mean, they make your photos look so good. And for YouTube, I have mentioned it many times before that I use Wondershare Filmora for editing my YouTube videos. The third question is from Rushi Parma 21. The question is, what are your views on Nick Hill and how did you become friends? Well, how do I say what are my views on Nick Hill? I mean, he's my friend since a very long time, but since you guys are asking me, so my views on Nick Hill is that he's an extremely straightforward, hardworking, and a completely different guy than most of us. I mean, he's very, very, what do you call it? He's so mannered, well-mannered, and he lives with certain rules. He's very different than us. He's extremely disciplined as a human being, and which I definitely am not, and he lives this completely well-disciplined life. So my views on him is that he is almost very close to perfect as a human being. And how did I and Nikhil become friends? Well, I think I answered this last time as well, but I'll answer it again anyways. So me and Nikhil, we became friends like around 3.5-4 years ago through a shoot that we did together. So we were shooting for an Savdhan episodic, and he was my co-star in there, and that's how we became friends. The fourth question is from Dhaval, and he is asking me, why don't you collab with some big web series makers? It will be awesome to see you act. So first of all, thank you so much. I mean, I really love acting, and I'm looking forward to an extremely good project and a good story to come my way, because I want to experiment with my characters, and I don't want to keep playing the normal boring characters that they show on TV and stuff. So I'm looking for a really good opportunity to come my way, and I'll definitely make the most of it. Also, why don't I collab with web series makers? So well, it's not that you cannot just collab with a web series makers, okay? Basically, you have to give an audition, you have to go through a series of rounds of auditions to finalize and bag a role, so which I can obviously do, but if you notice, web series nowadays show a lot of filth that they shouldn't be showing. I'm sorry, I'm being really straightforward and upfront here, that they show a lot of filth in terms of, like, you know what they show. I'm sure you guys already know. So I don't want to be a part of shows where they show filth and they show things that are bad and not good for the youth to see. Hence, I'm not being a part of them. The fifth question is from Nikhil, and he's asking me, what is your favorite holiday destination? So all the places that I've visited until now, amongst them, my favorite holiday destination has to be Leh Ladakh. I mean, it is one of the most beautiful places I've ever been to. None of the places compared to its beauty. It was that good. And second after that comes Macau. Both of these places are extremely beautiful, and you guys should definitely go there at least once in your lifetime. Now coming to the sixth question, and this is from Nitish. Life Lafde aur Bandiya ka second season hoga kya? So I'm really glad ki tum log mein se kisi ne to ye question pucha Q&A mein, because if you guys keep DMing me and asking me, is Life Lafde aur Bandiya season 2 coming or no, and I have told so many of you guys that it's not gonna come. So well, it's a little sad to say, but Life Lafde aur Bandiya is over and season 2 is not gonna be coming. The seventh question is from Mahima Gandhi 44, and her question is, how do you feel when people say that you and Nikhil are in a relationship? Well, to be honest, I and Nikhil, we both laugh it out, because it's actually funny that people assume things like without knowing anything. So we both laugh because people say whatnot, like, do you have a crush on him? Does he have a crush on you? Are you dating? Not saying it. So to be honest, my reaction is funny, and only unless people are sometimes crossing their limits in writing things about us, that's when I delete them. But mostly it's just funny and I just laugh it out. Now coming to question number 9, it is from Shivam Mahalle, and the question is, when is your next abroad trip? Well, my next abroad trip is in the month of December, and I cannot reveal the place right now because I'm not allowed to. So but yeah, it is happening in December. And question number 10 is from Yukta Palkar. I hope I'm pronouncing your name right. And which ride was the best ride yet? Okay, it has to be Leh Ladakh. It was one of the best rides of my entire life. I mean, I'm so glad that I could, and my parents allowed me, and Nikhil also took me along with him on this Leh Ladakh ride. It was so fun and such a learning experience for me. I learned so many things. I saw so many beautiful places. I met so many different people. I mean, it is the best riding experience, travel experience for me of my life, and I can never ever forget it. Seriously. Question number 11 is from Prakash, and his question is, what is your age? Well, I don't know if you guys know, I think I must have mentioned it, but my age is 22 as of now, and my birthday is 31st of July 1995. Question number 12 is from Raut Vedant 60, and he's asking me, Shanice, what is your qualification? Well, in terms of only studies, I am a BMM graduate. I just completed my graduation this year itself in April, and other than that, what else I have studied or learned is that I've done an acting course from Indian Television Academy, ITA, that was for 4 months. And apart from that, other qualifications is that I have learned Taekwondo, and I did not become a black belt, but I reached the red belt level. Question number 13 is a very interesting question, and it's from Ayush Singh 07. Will you join Big Boss if you have scope, or if there is scope? To be honest, no, I would never join Big Boss. And that's the thing, I mean, I and Nikhil never told you guys, but we were actually we got a call for the Big Boss that is happening right now on TV, and me and Nikhil both said no, because to be honest, I'm not quite a fan of Big Boss. Nothing offensive to you guys who love Big Boss, but I am not a fan of it. And being there is a big challenge, like putting your life out and leaving your family, staying without any phone or anything, all there. I mean, it's a difficult thing, and I do not want to do it at all. Question number 14 is from Naveen. What is your reactions when you see bad comments? Well, my reaction is like, why? I mean, it's weird, you know, for me it's very weird when I see people commenting bad things, because I feel that, I mean, they do not know us personally, they do not know me personally, and it's kind of weird that they assume things again and they comment whatever they feel like or whatever they want to. But to be honest, I ignore hate comments, and it's best that I ignore them, because we only encourage haters and make them happy if we give them attention, because all that they want is attention. So I choose to ignore haters, and all I react is that it is weird that you guys comment hate, why? And apart from that, when people cross their limits in terms of writing hate message and go and write about my family or about my character, that's when I cannot keep quiet and I have to give a very straightforward and blunt answer. And I think anyone should do it, because nobody has the right to cross their limits when it comes to commenting about you. Question number 15 is from Sadie_Insta. Which channel on YouTube do you follow and never miss the video of that particular channel? So my favorite YouTubers are Jess and Gabriel Conte. I love them so much. Like, they are the best and sweetest couple ever, and they're amazing YouTubers, both of them. And I just love how they vlog. I mean, I can completely connect to how they are, who they are. I mean, they're amazing human beings. So they are my favorite YouTubers and I love them, and I never miss any of the videos that they put up. Question number 16 is from _Rutu_12. What you feel about body shaming, and if you ever faced it, how did you overcome it? Well, about body shaming, I just feel it's a whole another level of stupidness that people have started doing to others. I mean, why would you body shame anyone? None of us are perfect. None of us are perfect in life, and we all have our own points that keep us a little back and don't let us be completely perfect as a human being. I just feel that body shaming should be completely stopped, and every human being should, like, never try to put some other human being down. About body shaming, if I have faced it, I have definitely faced it. So when I was in school in my secondary section, I think after I quit my taekwondo, I put on a lot of weight and I became very fat. So I heard bad comments and I got body shamed from my family, from my friends, from a lot of people, like strangers, and I used to feel really bad that time. So I was a very shy and pressed down person at that moment. I could not open up because it used to make me feel scared. It used to make me feel very shy, that oh my god, I can't go out, I can't wear this, I can't wear that. So I have faced it really badly, but then I actually overcame it, because when I came to college and there was vacations before my board exams results came out and before I could start college, what I started doing is I started going for morning walks, I started like running and all of that, and I actually lost a lot of weight by myself, all by myself. And after that, people started appreciating. So this is how fast people change their opinions. So please don't give a damn about people's opinions, because they say whatever they want to say and they will keep saying whatever they want to say, no matter how good or bad you are. And even now, I'm even facing it now on the internet. So basically, I was thin in the middle, then I put on weight again, and I'm not feeling shy about it. I did put on weight, and I know for myself that if I want to lose weight with regular workout, I can, but I'm just being a little lazy, to be honest. But I have started getting back at it from the past 2 days, so I'm happy. I'm motivated enough to lose weight again. So yeah, I mean, I'm still facing it. Like, when I was thin, people used to be like, hot, this, that, and whatnot. And now that I put on weight, like, what do you guys say? Like, so many of you guys, I cannot believe how boys comment that, but they say, yaar, please wait, uske tum moti hogi, tujhme interest nahi hai mujhe abhi. I mean, that is like the most funniest thing ever. Like, my body is for me, it's not for me to impress you. So anyways, like, body shaming, it's a stupid thing. Don't get your mind to it. Question number 17 is from Presha.Ashu. I don't know what's your name, Presha or Ashu, whatever it is, comment down. So her question is, are you somehow related to Nepal? Very curious to know it, because your caste is Shrestha, which belongs to the Nepalese caste. Well, yes, I am related to Nepal, if you guys don't know. So my dad is a Nepali and he belongs to Nepal, but he converted into Christian right before his marriage. And my mom is a Catholic and I follow Christianity as well. So I am a Christian. I am born and brought up in Mumbai itself. But yes, I am related to Nepal. I am sure now a lot of you guys ask me this question, so I hope you'll have the answer finally. Coming to question number 18. What are the three things you are afraid of? So well, the three things that I'm afraid of is heights. Obviously, I'm scared of heights, deep water. So I'm scared of deep pools, going to the ocean or whatever. So that's the reason I don't know swimming or couldn't learn swimming, because I'm afraid of water. And the third thing that I'm afraid of is darkness. Question number 19 is from Kuldeep. And his question is, what camera do you use to capture Instagram photos? Well, right now I'm using my G7X Mark II Canon to shoot all my pictures of Instagram, because the clarity is amazing, and I'm even shooting my video right now from that. And but before this, I used to use my Canon 60D camera to shoot pictures, and sometimes it used to even dodge between Nikhil's 80D Canon again. So yeah, these are the cameras that I have used for my Instagram photos. And I do not fail to use my iPhone 2 whenever I go out and travel, because iPhone also takes amazing pictures. And the last question, question number 20, is from Bike With Boy. His question is, what inspired you to start a YouTube channel? If you were not a YouTuber, then what would you probably be? So, like every another girl having dreams about her partner, what dreams do you have? Okay, so first of all, what inspired me to start a YouTube channel? Well, I never really wanted to start a YouTube channel, to be honest. I was forced by Nikhil to start a YouTube channel like 1.5 years or 2 years ago, I think. And he himself made a YouTube channel for me, and he was like, start uploading videos on YouTube. So yeah, that's it. So that's the truth about me starting my YouTube channel, to be very honest with you guys. Then his second question, because he's asked three questions, so his second question is, if you were not a YouTuber, then what you probably would be. So well, if I was not a YouTuber, I would definitely be an actor and a blogger, because acting is something I love and blogging is something I like to do. So I would definitely be a full-time blogger and actor. And then his last question is, like every another girl having dreams about her life partner, what do you have? So basically, when I was young, I used to be like all crazy, like how, so I went to a girls' convent school, so we got girls used to keep discussing about, you know, how a dream guy has to be and all of that. So when I was small in school and like even in college, 11th and 12th, I used to really go crazy about like, oh, what's my future boyfriend gonna be like? What is my husband gonna be like? And all of that things. But now, since I've become more matured, I really don't think about this life partner or boyfriend or ideal partner thing. But if ever I have to choose a guy, what qualities I would want that guy to have is, he should definitely be honest, hardworking, and should be an extremely, extremely good human being. That comes like the first most important point. You can have everything, but if you are not a good human being, I mean, I will not like that person. So yeah, that's it. So that was it for this video, guys. I answered all of your questions and I had so much fun answering all your questions, to be honest. So I hope ki tum logo bhi itna hi maza aaya jitna maza mujhe aaya aap sabke questions answer karne ke liye. I hope you had fun, and if you did have fun, don't forget to hit the like button. Do subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Also guys, I have a very special request for you guys today. Since I want to be regular on YouTube from now on, so I'm planning to film a lot of videos that you guys want to watch. So I would request all of you guys to leave ideas below in comment section and tell me what videos you want me to film next, so I can pick out some of your videos and film that for you guys. Also, I'm deciding that I'm going to start putting 2 videos every week. I will be sharing which days I'm going to select. Also, if you guys have some particular days that you want me to put videos on, then please leave that too in the comment section down below. Anyways, I'm done talking for today. So, bye-bye. Take care of yourself, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye-bye.